Hey, Star Wars fans, it's your bro host, Jan Solo, and I'm back with Marvel's issue number 12 of The High Republic, written by Kevin Scott. This one's called Jedi's End, Chapter 2, The Spirit of Disunity. Let's jump right in. We begin on Starlight Beacon, where Avar Chris is looking like she's hanging on by a thread. It's been a rough few weeks. Starlight has been all over the Outer Rim, and crisis after crisis have left Avar feeling exhausted. But what kind of trouble has Avar seen? Well, how about Lorna D slipping through the Jedi's proverbial fingers? Avar tried to summon the strength and the force to hold Lorna's ship from breaking gravity and getting out into orbit. But she, without the support of an injured Keeve or Skeer, she failed. Keeve narrates the scene. It haunts her. She wishes that she could have done more. Meanwhile, Avar's had enough of the humanitarian efforts. She interrupts a dialogue about water pumps to demand that the Jedi focus on the Great Hall, the Nihil base. As Avar storms off, Keeve faces Tarek and Carrot. They sit there almost lifeless, and guilt washes over Keeve. And then we flash back. A disagreement between Chris and Skeer. She reminds him of the orders that she gave him, orders that he ignored. Then and there, Avar demands that Skeer surrender his lightsaber to her. Alright, now Kevin Scott and the Marvel team give us a few more twists and turns in this issue that we just can't give away. So run, don't walk down to your nearest shop and pick up Marvel's issue number 12 of The High Republic. You will not be disappointed.
And make sure you check out the Star Wars Splash Page podcast for in-depth reviews on all the new Star Wars comics every week.
Hey guys, the 2021 annual from IDW is here, and it is all dedicated to the High Republic with five new stories from all the great crew. Charles Soule, Claudia Gray, Justina Ireland, Daniel Jose Older, Kevin Scott, they all feature a story with many of the great new characters we have grown to love over the last year. So without further delay, let's get into it. First up, Set for Life. We join the Jedi crew at the outpost on Elfrona, including Loden Greatstorm and his Padawan Bell Zedifar, plus their friend Indira and trusty pet Ember. An emergency arises at a mining facility that is endangering the life of a local. Loden and Bell race to the rescue, and Bell gets a bit more training from his master. Second up, we have No Stone Unturned, featuring Leox, Affy, and Geode. They've taken a slightly easier job after fighting the Jurangir in the Huts, a treasure hunt. But it appears the locals aren't going to make it that easy for them. Leox and Affy are on the run for their lives, but eventually find that the right words can fix more than the right weapons. Next, we have First Mission. We get a flashback to when Vernesta Rowe meets with her new master, Stellan Geos, for the first time. Master Geos invites her to spar with him and learns quickly how gifted she is. They go to a banquet between the Huts and the Hynestians, and you know that if the Huts are involved, you won't make it through the first course without some blaster fire, which means a trial by fire for our young Padawan Vern. Fourth is Crash and the crew do what they do. Crash and, well, the crew, have been hired to be Chancellor Lena So's insurance during her visit to Corellia, meaning they need to keep their eyes peeled for threats against her. And of course, it wouldn't be a party without a party pooper, nor would it be a great comic without a little action. Luckily, we get both, plus a familiar friend at the end who's behind it all. Finally, we end with The Hall. The Nihil are attacking a vault, looking for another big win, but a storm named Slombo is having troubles getting through. No worries, Lorna D swoops in to be of assistance. Slombo isn't all too happy to get her help, but in the end, his greed gets the better of him. I don't think this haul will be all he was hoping it would be. These stories are fantastic. They're full of great adventure, great art, and even some great wisdom. And honestly, if this is the first High Republic comic you pick up, it's good enough to where you don't have to be all caught up on every story of the High Republic to enjoy it. So make sure to add this one to your collection today.
Joining us for another quick shot of Bro Axiom.
If you dig our content, please give this video a like and our channel a subscribe.
Make sure you check out our merch at our Tee Public store and consider checking out our new Patreon page and help support Bro Axiom. And may the Force be with you.
Always.